Kids across America are in debt because school lunch is so expensive. But for the corporate media, this seems normal and an opportunity to teach us a lesson about morality under capitalism.
Paying off school lunch debt for everybody at his school in the second grade and students at six other schools. Keone Ching, how did you do this? Of Vancouver, Washington, raised more than $4,000 selling special bracelets. His principal says the eight-year-old just wanted to do something to celebrate the school's kindness week. What a fabulous idea.
Look how excited CNN is about a little boy raising money to pay off his classmates' student lunch debt. Instead of, I don't know, interrogating why eight-year-olds have student lunch debt.
About $500 is left over from the donation, and now it's going to be used to cover future lunch debts at the school.
Does CNN think its role is to train Americans for a future of debt? Credit card debt, student debt, medical debt, layaway. It's the American dream. Good job, CNN. Way to turn inequality into a puff piece instead of drawing attention to the fact that our education system is so screwed up that students are indentured servants at age 7. It's happening all around the country. In some schools, kids have their lunches taken away from them and thrown in the trash because of lunch debt. In one Pennsylvania school district, parents were threatened with having their children put in foster care if they didn't settle the lunch debt, which ranged from $12.50 to $450. This is a common theme in corporate media. Inspirational moral lessons about inequality that divert attention away from societal and institutional failures that cause the problem, and instead make it about an individualist savior story about Good Samaritans. Like the increasingly common praise of people donating their sick days to coworkers who need cancer treatment so they don't lose their job and pay. I know what you're thinking. There can't possibly be a way to spin this into a feel-good story. Wait for it.
We've been following Robert Goodman's journey since the summer when he posted a plea on Facebook asking fellow teachers to donate sick days while he battled cancer. His community of educators once again offering up their PTO grabbed the attention of the Today Show with Kathy Lee and Huda. His story chosen as one of their end-of-the-year feel-good stories tomorrow.
These television aristocrats are so disconnected from the hardships most Americans face that they can't question a system which forces people to choose between work and staying alive. Their children munch on gourmet meals in the best private schools, while other kids worry about no lunch at all.
Let them eat cake.
Corporate media acts like people are stepping in to help in the face of a natural disaster or something, rather than filling in where the system is rigged against them. If the media covered these stories the way they should be covered, people might realize just how unequal and vicious capitalism is. And we might wonder if it's wrong for children to be in debt just because those greedy spoiled brats want to have lunch every day.
Lisa, I want some more.
America has more billionaires than any other country, and it also has one of the highest child poverty rates in the industrialized world. Billionaires control our politicians. They make the rules to benefit themselves to the detriment of the rest of us. And they own the media, which is how you get upbeat stories about the Dickensian conditions faced by the poor that leave you feeling warm and fuzzy instead of like this. If the media told the truth, people might wonder why a country that spends $738 billion a year on the military can't afford to provide 8-year-olds with free lunch or allow sick people to take the necessary time they need off work for treatment and recovery. They might start asking why companies like Amazon pay $0 in taxes, while the student homeless population skyrockets to 1.5 million, the highest in over a decade. If the media started asking questions like that, Americans just might get angry enough to do something about it. We wouldn't want that, now would we?